even though we had, you know, our partners come out to Australia and, you know, sort of witness some different testing that we were doing and understand the machine performance better, they always want you to take the machine there. Seeing is believing, but they always want it operating on the ground, in their conditions, in their environment, with their regulators around and their clients and customers around, to be able to properly gauge what everybody thinks. It was mid-pandemic when we first started socialising our technology with different groups in the USA. That culminated us in achieving some meeting opportunities. And from there, over a period of 1 or 2 years, we decided that conducting a pilot program and socialising the tech with the building community would be the next best step. And then from there, things tended to accelerate. I think we could both see a very good opportunity to servitize the laying of wall for builders as opposed to just selling bricks and blocks. One of the biggest challenges you have when you're undertaking a pilot program on the other side of the world is the time, the amount of time that things take to do and the cost to do those things. Just the shipping time alone for a 30-ton machine to go to the United States and the logistics around that. And then, of course, the logistics around putting the right people, the right skill sets on the ground at the right time. And then dealing with all the nuances and logistics of dealing with builders and contractors and regulators. So there are a lot of challenges there, but you know, we knew what that was going to be like going in. We'd done enough research and work on the ground in the US beforehand, so no surprises, but it was still a lot of work.
The team really enjoyed coming over to Florida. When we were there, it was very hot and incredibly humid. We have a saying in FBR, it's the same, but it's different, but it's the same. So, you know, there's a lot of similarities. You know, bricks and blocks are pretty similar all over the world, but it's the small differences that can make a big difference. You know, so here in Australia, we typically build on flat sand sites where the slabs are at about the same elevation as the rest of the building site. In Florida, most of the slabs are built up to a metre above ground level, so, you know, you have to adapt to that. Obviously, they're building for a hurricane area, so there's a lot of rebar, which is not typically used here in Western Australia, but we'd figured out how to do that, and we've done, you know, trial builds like that at our Sultana Road facility, you know, for the Mexico market, European market, and even for the US market. Most other places in the world, you know, they're more familiar with building with wet mortars than with a construction adhesive. Some of that involved explaining to the builders that, yeah, it's different materials, but it's all been approved and it's as good or better in many ways than the way you've been doing it in the past. You know, and that can follow right through to building inspection and engineer approval and all those sorts of things. But, you know, significantly, we did all of that and we showed that it works.
And then, of course, you get all the unforeseen challenges that arise, like, you know, significant weather events. We did experience quite a few hurricanes through the last tropical season there in Florida, more than normal. Some of those held us up. It doesn't just hold us up, it actually disrupts the whole flow of work for the builders and the contractors. So you only got to get a couple of heavy days of rain and then, you know, the earthworks that people have done on their sites in preparation for their slabs to go down, that dirt gets washed away, so that work has to be redone. So you're constantly moving your program around to fit in to the schedules of the builders. The homes that we built in the US were for real builders to be finished off for real customers. We didn't put our own slabs down. We couldn't just apply to the regulatory authorities, the county, to lay our own slabs, buy our own lots of land, build our own homes and go through that process. We had to work with the builders who are producing hundreds, if not tens of thousands of homes per year, understand when slabs are likely to be ready. We didn't ask them for any changes to their designs. We needed our technology to fit into their design programs and platforms and their methodologies. We simply wanted to present our technology as a better, faster, cheaper option. But yeah, the homes that we built there were for builders that were planning on building those homes with or without FBR's involvement.
Once we arrive at site, it's a matter of unpacking Hadrian, getting the tracking equipment set up, cleaning off the slab, generally making sure that all the pre-work has been done, and then we get into loading Hadrian with blocks. Then the laying process generally proceeds pretty smoothly. We have our person in the zone, or our PIZ guys, who do the quality control and any minor adjustments during the build process, and then we place lintels when we're at that particular height. On some builds, that's the end of the build. On others, we have to place blocks over the top of those lintels. And then at the end, it's a quick site cleanup, because really Hadrian doesn't make very much mess at all. So the site cleanup's pretty quick. And then get off the site, demobilise and get back on the float and either go to the next site if that's been prepared, or back to the Green Meadows facility.
And if you look at that wild weather event we had on our planned demonstration day, regardless of the fact that we didn't actually get the demonstration done, we were able to bring a bunch of very interested and like-minded people to the Green Meadows site. We still had a great day, even though we all got wet and our hairdos got blown around. That was still a very worthwhile event to undertake.
Building a house in a day is a really significant commercial milestone, and very important, because what it means is that you can deploy to the site, do all the work that's needed, get off the site, it's all done in one day, and that means you can schedule, you know, basically a house every day. It's really significant. We would have liked to have done that earlier in the program, and we were actually on track, and you know, bar some weather events associated with a hurricane coming through the Fort Myers area, you know, we would have achieved that much earlier, particularly bearing in mind that particular Hadrian X had never built a house structure outside of our Sultana Road facility before it went to the US. So that's a pretty big win for FBR, and a demonstration, you know, that really the technology works.
You can build a home in a day with 50 bricklayers or masons too. So it's one of those things that it sort of polarizes discussion sometimes, because it's about, well, what are we competing against exactly? What we're trying to present is an efficient method of building home structures for builders, which over time, and as the problem gets even larger from where it is at the moment, as we see an even greater decline in the number of masons and bricklayers around the world, you know, this is an obvious next choice in terms of building the walls of homes around the world. And, you know, it's no fluke that we can build with almost any brick or block product manufactured around the world of any type, and build any design of home for any builder.
We've got a really good continuous improvement process. We collect a huge amount of data from Hadrian, and most of that data is fed back in real time back to Australia. We also collect a lot of quality control data, such as images of every single adhesive application and things like that. Every little fault which happens during the operation, and also the performance of all the different modules inside Hadrian, all of that is logged and captured and fed back to Hadrian, and our engineers go through that data. You know, because when we're in the US, we're not just doing the demonstration program. We're also looking at different kinds of markets over there. There's a lot of commercial building, not just residential stuff. There's also military building, which happens over there. You know, for example, up in Tallahassee, they're building massive big brick and block hangars, which are hurricane proof. You know, and Hadrian would be perfect for that kind of work. We just don't have enough Hadrians to actually go up there and do it. So it's a matter of collecting the data and also looking around at all the different kinds of opportunities which are out there.
But at the end of the day, we got to a point where we believed we had completed enough home structures with enough builders and clients around to gather the information we needed to move forward. Look, over the years, we've brought together some amazing relationships with some overseas partner companies, and everyone's watching us or watching the program very closely. You know, it is a validation point for FBR and for the Hadrian machines. I mean, we are conducting this work in Florida, where we see the market as being absolutely ideal for the Hadrian machine, you know, with the types of residential home structures, the designs, the building environment, the types of products that they use. And I think overall the appetite of builders there for innovation. But, you know, overall, there are a lot of people who are, you know, rooting for us in the background for success, and a lot of people waiting to see what's going to occur from this and, you know, what this will potentially catalyse.
When you bring new tech to market, there's a whole bunch of different validations which have to happen. And the way we step through that is what we call a factory acceptance test, which proves that the tech works in the factory, but that's nothing like the real environment. The next step towards that is a site acceptance test, where we prove that the tech actually works out on site. The next step after that is to commercially validate it, you know, and prove that you can actually go out and do it in the timeframes that are needed, that you can deploy and mobilise and demobilise to the site, and that you can get employees and train them and do all the different things which you have to do to actually tackle a market. And FBR is now so far along that validation process, you know, not just in Australia, but also as far away from Australia as you can get. You know, you cannot get further away than the east coast of the US. So, you know, we're ready to take on the world.